Today, I want to talk about VSync in Star Citizen. It's a very misunderstood topic, VSync, and we're going to look at what it is, why it exists, and what it looks like in game, and whether you should probably have it on or off. So, let's get into it. So first of all, what is VSync trying to fix? And in this clip here that I'll show you, we'll see the screen tearing. Now this video is actually talking about GSync, which is another technology which we'll come on to a bit later in the video. But first of all, this is the same thing. Screen tearing is an issue that GSync and VSync and FreeSync, all these syncs, fix. And the issue is that as you kind of move left to right, as you move your character's head around, especially sideways, you have these artifacts where the screen tears. The frames are not in sync and you get these weird bits where parts of the image have moved and they're off center, and it just looks awful. And I've been saying for a long time now that there's no good spending all this money on getting the best system that you possibly can if you're then having it ruined by terrible screen tearing. So what VSync does, in a very simple explanation, is it syncs up the output from the graphics card to the refresh rate of your monitor. So for instance, if you've got a refresh rate monitor 60 hertz, it will stop. If you turn VSync on, it will stop your graphics cards going any higher than 60 hertz, so they'll be locked. Here's some images from Star Citizen to kind of demonstrate this. Now this is on my minimum spec system, so we're actually not always hitting 60 fps, and so what happens then is that if it can then hit 30 fps, it will do that. Sometimes 45 it will try and aim at, and you'll see here as I toggle VSync on and off by just tabbing out the game, you'll see what happens and how you can actually lose performance by having VSync enabled. So you'll see sometimes when it's off, there'll be screen tearing, but the frame rate can just go as high as it likes. But when you turn it on, you're locked to the highest stable frame rate that it can get, that it can kind of get into 60 fps. I do normally game at 144 hertz, but in this case I've just used a HDMI cable for my minimum spec system, so it is actually just locked to 60 fps in this case, or 60 hertz in this case. If we look at a 60 fps example, you'll see the game has the potential to go higher, but in order to meet the VSync frame rate, or to sync everything up, it will drop it down. So what is the downside to VSync then, apart from losing some frames? Well, input lag. If you use VSync, it increases your input lag. So the response between you moving things on your mouse or your keyboard and actually what you see on screen. And that isn't a great solution. Now, there are other solutions like FastSync from NVIDIA. I assume AMD have got their own equivalent, or Adaptive Sync. And they are slightly different technology that actually are an improvement on VSync itself. What about G-Sync and FreeSync? G-Sync is NVIDIA's option, AMD has FreeSync. What do? Well, they match the monitor refresh rate to the GPU output. So, say your GPU is outputting 120 FPS, that is the rate that the monitor will refresh. So it basically matches the monitor refresh rate to the GPU output. And so that is the best case scenario, because there's a range in which it works, but generally G-Sync, but from something like 30 FPS, maybe a bit lower, upwards to the top ranges of your monitor, it will sync up all the way through those, which brings the best performance in terms of there's not anywhere near as much input lag, and just generally a great experience. And I highly, highly recommend G-Sync and FreeSync, or FreeSync. They're obviously more money, that's the thing, the monitors will cost more money, but again, as I say, if you've spent the money to get a decent rig for Star Citizen especially, you have to top that off by getting a good monitor with some sort of version of these two, G-Sync or FreeSync. It would just be such a shame to have the whole experience ruined by terrible screen tearing. So the question, would I have it on or off VSync? Well, obviously, if you've got a monitor with G-Sync or FreeSync, just use those, they're better. Star Citizen isn't massively kind of a twitchy based shooter or anything like that, and there's so many issues going on in terms of server performance and probably just network sync and things like that, that actually having a bit more input lag isn't going to hurt your performance from your own gaming performance. It's not going to suddenly take you from being like an FPS ninja to being just terrible at shooting people. I don't think that's the case. So if you have a situation, this is going to depend on your spec, where actually you're not losing many frames by turning VSync on. So say you're hovering around the 35 FPS mark in parts of the game anyway, it's not going to hurt you much to go down to 30 FPS in that case, and I think you'll have a better experience because of a lack of screen tearing. But say you've actually got quite a few frames and you're losing a lot, say you're more averaging, I don't know, say you're averaging maybe 100 FPS and it's going to drop you down to 60 and you've got a monitor that will go that high, you're probably not going to enjoy the experience as much, because even though you'll have more screen tearing, you'll have lost quite a few frames. And it really depends on what you notice and what you, when you are gaming, can see in terms of your own eyes. Not everybody will even notice the difference between something like 60 FPS and 120 FPS. Some people won't even notice screen tearing, and to be honest, until I actually used the G-Sync monitor, I hadn't noticed as how bad screen tearing was. It's one of those things that once you've tried out G-Sync or FreeSync, then you can't really go back. But if you're kind of living in that blissful unaware state where you're like, well, that's fine, maybe you can just get away with having VSync on and or off even, and you wouldn't really care. But there we go. The main reason why I've done this video is because lots of people don't understand this, and lots of people will say, why have my performance been locked to 30 FPS? And so often when you're kind of answering questions, or when somebody posts on Reddit, it's like, what's going on with my performance? The main question that people ask first of all is, do you have VSync on or off? And you obviously have the option to turn it off or on in game, but depending on what settings you have within your GPU control panel, NVIDIA's, this is the example for NVIDIA, it might be locked on in there anyway. If you've got it on, it will override what's in game. So just make sure you know what you're doing and you understand, because it can be used really well, VSync, but actually probably most people would want to have it turned off. That's enough of this one. If you like this more technical look at Star Citizen, subscribe, like the video if you liked it, and I'll see you soon. Bye.